This will be a very short video, but I nevertheless want to contribute a bit of content to this channel, especially now that I plan to revive it, and I also want to talk about a small topic. I will show you two maps, and these two maps show areas which were once inhabited by Germans in modern-day Transylvania. And these two maps are from the 19th century on the one hand. This is the second map that we will take a look at. And the first map that you can see right now actually shows areas which were inhabited by Germans in the High Medieval period. But let's talk first about how these German minorities in this area even came to be. This area was originally conquered by Hungarians in the aftermath of the migration period, and they established their kingdom there. And they were at war with Eastern peoples, such as mainly steppe peoples. And to establish their reign over this territory, they had to establish its structures further. And overall, they simply planned to make this land more productive. And one important decision that the Hungarian kings actually made, we talk about the early 12th and especially the 13th century, so a classical medieval period, was that they resettled Germans from modern-day Germany into this area and gave them certain freedoms so that they could build cities and villages over there and overall just establish a very typical medieval landscape. Which is also one of the reasons why the landscape of Transylvania up to this day is actually somewhat comparable to other classical Central European landscapes. Among these newly found villages and cities, there were seven very important cities, and according to this, in German, this region was known as Siebenbürgen, which therefore is the German name for Transylvania, although in German also the word Transylvanien exists. But over the time, these areas, which were at the medieval period at the top of the expansion, started to decline. And in Transylvania of the 19th century, only these areas, which you can see now, actually remained. Although, as you can see, especially in the west and also in some eastern areas, other areas were resettled by Germans, and a main reason both for the decline of the Transylvanian Saxon settlements at the one hand and the settlement of other German groups in the neighboring areas were actually the Turkish wars, which were very devastating and in general had a relatively large impact on ethnicity in this region. Nowadays, and especially since the aftermath of the Second World War, there is next to nothing that remains of these settlement areas, but I think it is nonetheless a neat historical topic. Something that is quite interesting is also that the name of this German group was actually Siebenbürger Sachsen in German, and you would literally translate this as Transylvania Saxons. And this is also kind of interesting because it is possible that the word Saxon, or in German Sachsen, was originally the word by which Germans were designated in this part of Europe. This is actually somewhat similar to the word that, for example, Finnish and Estonian people still use to describe Germans, which is Saxa, and all of it derives from the name of the old Saxon tribe. But that would be already all for this very short video. I think that this kind of short video is also a kind of video that I could imagine I would upload more often on this channel, and as always, I hope that you will watch the next video also again. See you then!